Hi, God bless you. This is your brother Ferdinand, and here is Truth in Brief for today. We are still focusing on the fact that in powerful praying, the size of your prayers matter. And in the last one, we saw God saying to his people, open your mouth wide and I will fill it. I am the one that brought you out of the land of Egypt. It's me. I did all those mighty miracles and I have never changed. Open your mouth wide and I will fill it. Take away all the distractions and maximize the access that you have towards me. And today we are in Isaiah chapter 7, and God is speaking to a king here called Ahaz. He was attacked. Ahaz was king of Judah, and then he was attacked by, Pekah the son of Remaliah, and then Rezin the king of Syria. They were confederate, and they ganged up against him, and Isaiah came to tell him that God was going to send salvation. And Ahaz was not so sure. God said to him in verse 9, said, if you will not believe, surely you shall not be established. So faith is important. He said, if you won't believe, you will not be established. He said, believe in the Lord your God, so shall you be established. And then believe his prophets that speak his word, and that is how you are going to prosper. But now in verse 11, God now spoke to Ahaz again. And he said in verse 11, ask a sign for yourself from the Lord your God. Ask it either in the depth or in the height above. God said, ask a sign to confirm to you that what I've promised is going to come to pass. God said, ask a sign. I like to read the thing for you from some other translations. The Amplified Bible said, ask for yourself a sign, a token or proof of the Lord your God, one that will convince you that the Lord has spoken and will keep his word. Ask it either in the depth below or in the height above. Let it be as deep as Sheol or as high as heaven. God is challenging somebody. God said, pray your prayer. And when you are going to pray this prayer, let your prayer be as deep as the underworld, Sheol, the place of the dead. Or let it be as high as the highest heavens. Ask it. God is telling him, I'm giving you a blank check. Ask for the sign that you want. And this one said, make a request to the Lord your God for a sign. A sign in the deep places of the underworld or in the high heavens. See, the man who is going to pray the prayer does not have access to the deep places of the underworld. He does not have access to the heights of heaven. But God said, when you are going to ask, ask beyond your reach. Ask beyond your capacity. Ask beyond your ability. And watch what he says here now. I like the way the Message version puts it. Let me quickly read that for you here. The Message version said, ask for a sign from your God. Ask anything. Be extravagant. Ask for the moon. He said, be extravagant. Ask for the moon. God said, ask anything. And then the man that God was talking to, he says, hey, I don't want to tempt the Lord my God. I don't want to ask. God said, okay, you are not going to ask. He said, I will not ask. No, neither will I test God. God said, I'm the one who is giving you the blank check. Do you know some people, what is keeping them back from praying great prayers, powerful prayers that will change their generation? They say, well, if you pray like that now, you may be tempting God. If you ask that kind of thing, you may be asking for too much. You don't know who you are dealing with. That's why you are thinking like that. He said, be extravagant. No wonder in the New Testament, he said, whatsoever things you desire, when you pray, believe. Can you imagine somebody who will give you such a blank check? And then he says, ask. He says, I don't want to test God. God said, okay, the Lord himself will give you a sign. I'm going to give you a sign by myself. Now watch the sign that God gave. He said, behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son and shall call his name Emmanuel. Do you understand? God said, okay, I'm going to give you a sign. I will give the ultimate sign of deliverance. A virgin will conceive. When the virgin conceives and brings forth a son, then you will know that what I've said will come to pass in your life. And do you know, for us, this thing was a prophecy back in the book of Isaiah. But for us, we live on this side of the New Testament. The virgin has conceived. The virgin has brought forth. The fact that the virgin has brought forth the perfect, sinless Son of God and he has paid the price is a guarantee. So you can see the sign is bigger than the problem. See, the man needs deliverance from these two kings who are attacking him. Pekah, the son of Remaliah from Israel in the north, and then Syria, Rezin, king of Syria, they were coming against him. That's the problem. But God is giving a sign that is bigger than the problem. God, do you know that the finished work of our Lord Jesus Christ is bigger than any problem you can ever have? God giving his son, he has given you something bigger to guarantee to you that there is nothing else that you can ask for that will be too much for him to give to you. He said, be extravagant. Ask for the moon. When you are praying your prayers, don't pity God. Open your mouth wide. Pray crazy prayers. So when the answer comes, it will be clear to you that this is not you at work. This is God. Look, when I pray, I'm asking for continents. I'm asking for nations. He said, ask of me and I will give you the nations for your inheritance, the uttermost parts of the earth for your possession. Just look at the promises of God and you will realize that God is not looking for people who are small in heart and whose requests will not bring him glory. Be extravagant. Ask for the moon. Look at human beings are now flying into space and they are trying to colonize the place and go and be doing tourism in the place. And as a child of God, you are looking for something small. Let me just manage it. No, your father owns heaven and earth. Be bold in your request. And you are going to see God's power do for you what you never could do for yourself. Father, we receive this word. In the name of Jesus, now we are asking for the impossible. Let it manifest in the life, in the life of this sister. There's a woman watching this telecast. The power of God is touching you as you are watching this and making a way where there seems to be no way in your situation. Father, we thank you for everyone else reaching out in faith, Lord, to receive and to believe you. Father, open the windows of heaven and rain a blessing and answers upon them, such as they never could achieve by themselves. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless you. God bless you. Remember, be extravagant in your praying, and you will find that God is faithful. Bye-bye.